Well, we had seen the stories yesterday that Harford County began the installation of cameras along certain portions of the Mom Pa Trail. And we got more information that it was going to be a project of about $1.2 million. A lot of questions from you, the listeners, and from me, myself, right? When you are looking at cameras as a solution to address the concern that people are feeling. This was a decision that was made with probably a lot of partners, a lot of stakeholders involved, but chief among those stakeholders and really the one where the buck stops is the county executive, Bob Cassilly, who is joining us now. And County Executive Cassilly, thanks so much for joining the program. You know, we got the news that you've got this camera project is going to be installed. I'll tell you, the response has been a little mixed, but if you don't mind, just give our listeners an idea of what exactly is this project and why do you feel this was the right way to address the concerns that people have had along this trail?
Sure, Torrey. Good afternoon. Good to, thanks for having me on. So listen, just to put it all in perspective, I had 8 years in the Senate demonstrating my firm commitment that the best way to fight crime was to support the police and push back on soft on crime bills. And I did that. I mean, I'm the guy who filibustered the and defeated for a year the juvenile justice soft on juvenile justice bill and kept that down for a year. I pushed back. I was a leader in pushing back in the Senate as the minority leader. I'm sorry, as the minority member on the Judicial Proceedings Committee and pushing back against the soft on crime bills, the defund the police bills and the like. But you know what? We were not successful. And the current, I now come in as county executive and not a legislator. And now I have to deal with the tools that have given me. And so that's what we're doing. We've got several miles of the Mom Pa Trail, very popular trail. You go on there prior to Rachel Morin's murder. It was not uncommon to be on there getting towards the evening. You'd have young high school girls jogging on there, even maybe middle school people, elderly people, just a lot of trust put in that piece of the trail. Not a high crime area. In fact, sort of a zero crime area for decades. We've been very fortunate. So unfortunately, this really tragic murder and her body was discovered on the trail. And really shook the community seriously and their ability to feel comfortable on the trail. I mean, a real tragedy for obviously not just the Morin family, but for everybody. So now I'm put in a position of how do we monitor these, 24/7, 365, how do we monitor this effectively and cost effective? We put police where the crime is, not the idea where you put police everywhere crime might be, we have to have a pretty large sheriff's office, but we really have to focus our police presence where the crime is, and that's not on the Mom Pa Trail. So how do we provide a level of constant monitoring? Well, the only cost effective means to do that was through surveillance cameras. I mean, these have become the state of the art has really reached a pretty amazing level where we're going to have 26 poles out there with four cameras on each pole. These things have a lot of fidelity. They're able to be monitored by artificial intelligence, and they'll be there 24/7, 365. They have infrared capability. I mean, for me to provide that level of constant surveillance on this thing through police would just cost far more than the $1.2 million we're estimating. And once we put this in, the majority of that cost is for the hardware, the infrastructure, the poles, the fiber optic cable, the power cables. That stuff is going to be in for decades. I hear somebody say, well, they're easily destructible. Now, these are metal poles. These are mounted up on metal poles. Sure, somebody can try to climb a metal pole while they're being filmed on the camera, and the camera is alerting the people back in our 911 center that someone's trying to take out this camera. You can try that. I mean, you're going to...
So these are very tall, like I'm guessing like telephone pole style cameras?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. They're up... They're all sighted professionally, so each camera's got two far cameras, two near cameras, and they're monitoring the trail. And from a budget standpoint, this is a winner. I couldn't possibly afford this level of constant surveillance by humans. And what really sold us was looking at the demonstrations we saw of the artificial intelligence and just how accurate this stuff is to be able to continually monitor this and alert us as we need to. And I have areas, and this is sort of the beginning for us, because I have areas throughout the county where the issue isn't so much people, but property. I have parks in remote areas that we've got. You know, it's not tough to put $1 million in park equipment at a remote area of the county. And so I've got to be able to protect those investments as well. So we're really looking at this thing, the mom and pop store, the beginning, but it lets us protect our substantial investments as well as the public safety.
Quick question. So you mentioned that each pole has 4 cameras on them, and I've seen some numbers that this is going to include about 26 cameras. Are these 26 camera sites, or right. Is that 8 sites, you know, divided with all the cameras?
That's 26 camera sites.
Oh, okay.
Sites. So each site is a pole. Each pole's got 4 cameras on it. That's right.
Okay. And so with the surveillance, and let's talk a little bit about the hardware itself. Yeah. These are, I'm guessing these aren't the typical, you know, camera on a swivel. Are they encased in, like, you know, weatherproofing material, things like that, that would make them hard to disrupt or to shoot at or something?
That's right. You're exactly right. That's what these look like.
Okay. Okay. So that answers one question. I guess the follow up question is, let's talk about the AI monitoring, because I know that, sure. You know, I am no Luddite. I think that technology is really helpful. It can be useful in certain circumstances, but I do question: is this a situation where AI will be monitoring for anomalies, and only people, like the humans, will only be notified if the AI thinks that something is up?
That's right. It's anomalies. It's not. We are not doing facial recognition. We could do that. These are good cameras, but we think that's not appropriate. So if there's an attack, say, we could use the footage we get, the video, we can turn that over to the police, and it would be good enough for them to do facial recognition. But if you're a hardened criminal walking along the trail, just taking a walk and minding your own business, this is not going to pick you out.
Okay. So we're speaking with County Executive Bob Cassilly, talking about the cameras being installed. I know that for many folks, they are curious, you know, about the response time, right? If something were to happen, is this just documenting something that may happen? Like, are there protocols in place to make sure there's a rapid response in case something does happen?
Yeah, absolutely. So the way we're setting this up is that the monitors will actually be at our 911 center. The artificial intelligence, the centers would be there. And so it would alert the folks right there in dispatch, you know, an anomaly on camera 17. I'm just giving an example. Mm-hmm. And they could look at it and say, oh, that guy just stumbled and he got up and he left. Don't worry about it. Or they could say, whoa, and dispatch either, you know, whatever's appropriate immediately. They could dispatch police or ambulance to the exact pole and provide help. Yes.
So accompanying this strategy, is there also collaboration with law enforcement to ensure, you know, a quicker, swift response when something does happen? Because again, staffing is an issue everywhere. You don't want to be in a situation where something happens, but the police are, you know, 5 or 6 minutes away. Can people feel confident that if these cameras pick something up, that there would be enough time to get there to perhaps save someone's life?
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously, I can't provide any guarantees. What I can tell you is we have an excellent response time for our countywide, our sheriff's offices, which is our countywide police, our state police, and the 3 municipal police. And we dispatch them, and they all have an excellent response time. The trail isn't like buried in the north end. It's fairly close to the urban areas, although it is ice, you know, it's treed and you know, there's nothing over there. I got the town police at one end. I got the state police headquarters at the other end. Mm-hmm. And I've got county police that are, you know, the sheriff's office is monitoring in the middle. So I'm confident that we will be able to get a pretty rapid response. And most of the trail would be accessible to, you know, your normal police cruisers can pull there. So it's not like it's four wheelers and stuff.
We're local law enforcement resources part of the decision making process and getting the buy-in for this?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. Oh, okay, well, I mean, that answers questions. I do wonder, did you entertain other ideas like more rangers or patrols or, you know, just people just, you know, walking up and down the trail? Was that part of the discussion? And are there other mitigation factors that you're considering?
So we've got trail monitors, you know, folks who just walk the trail, just, you know, make sure the litter's up, report things. They have cell phones. So we do have that. We did consider using, we call them our fire police, that we looked at that. But the level of commitment was not something they wanted to do. Their job really isn't to do this kind of full-time monitoring. And, you know, we've got park rangers out. The state has park rangers out and about. But, you know, if you're going to, you know, we've got folks in different parks, but, you know, in the end, I can't provide the level of constant surveillance right. that you really need to get this done. And so I think that's a part of it. I mean, these things are infrared. I will have 24/7, 365, not only on this, but it gives me the ability to expand this to other, again, key sites in the county that are isolated. And I've got playground equipment that's, you know, it's not tough to spend $500,000 or $1 million on playground equipment these days, and that they're often in parks, and for me to be able to monitor that and alert police if somebody's damaging, you know, that kind of equipment is a huge plus. So, you know, I talk to other counties throughout that are well ahead of us before we did this. Not just me, but mm-hmm. our team talked to folks throughout the state, looking who's doing this and their successes. And you know, it's a worthwhile investment if you do it right. It's a very worthwhile investment. I think we're trying to do it right so that it's not. I didn't want this to be a token. I didn't want sort of, oh, there's a camera pole and a lousy camera up there. It's just there to pretend. No, we want to, if we're going to do it, we want a camera system that can actually not only detect crime, but help to solve crimes. And so that's what we're investing in. And I think it's a very worthwhile investment considering this is a long-term investment that can be expanded to other areas and allows our police to focus on, you know, active crime, active investigations, not just patrolling these areas that, quite frankly, we haven't seen crime on here for years. I mean, we had some break-ins at the parking lots on the end of the trail. We've had those before, but not on the trail. And we use cameras on the ends of the trails, quite frankly, to help alleviate that.
There's a saying I like to say, what looks like resistance is often a lack of clarity. I'm curious, is there anywhere where residents or people can learn more about the cameras and the systems? Because, I mean, look, a lot of the details that you're sharing with me, now that I hear them, it's kind of interesting. Is there a website or where can people learn more about these systems?
I mean, we just put the procurements out for some of, I mean, the different pieces of it. The poles have already, you're going to start seeing the poles installed. So if folks want to see that, you'll start seeing the poles installed sort of up along the William Street entrance of the trail. As far as the camera system, we haven't put that up on the website or anything, but we'll take a look at that. Forward.
And the AI part, I can tell you a lot of people were like, well, AI is monitoring what? So maybe that might be something I might just put on your radar to kind of provide clarity on that. But seriously.
It's exciting. I can tell you, I was really doubtful myself. And we watched demonstrations from, I think, three different vendors on this stuff. And the technology is very impressive. It's being used. It's expanding. It gets better, you know, all the time. And it really lets us, you know, maintain a visual surveillance without taking police time to just say, watch a trail and maybe nothing will happen for the next 6 months. You know, it's okay. Like, wow.
I appreciate you coming and having this conversation with us, and certainly interested to hear what the audience feels about it. Thanks for the work that you continue to do in Harford County, and best of luck with the rollout. We don't want you to be in Harford County's situation where they tried a new fancy thing with buses and everything went awry, but this is, I do feel like, you know, this is a little more stable. So I'm very curious, and I'm more interested in learning more about the AI component. So thanks for your time. Take care.
You take care.
Bye. All right. That was County Executive Bob Cassilly. And he, you know, gave us some more details about the camera system. I mean, look, some of the stuff that he shared, you know, if you've got these protected cameras, they're way up high, like a telephone pole. I feel a little bit better about it. I am very curious how you feel about it. I know we have Harford County residents and people just in different parts. We had conversations about parks in Baltimore City. Are surveillance cameras really what people are looking for? Is this something that's going to make people feel better? Let's discuss that a little more in depth when we get back. Torrey Snow, WBAL.